Look at him, he's a lovely one. Yes, perfect.
You come to Sandhurst for a biggin, and that is definitely a biggin.
It's mid-September, the weather is absolutely prime and we are down at Sandhurst Lake, arguably one of the best day tickets in the country. I've managed to secure a really good swim, it's been doing bites, I'm super excited. We're just on the way to dip the nets in the mat and I'm going to get going. Well, the rain is well and truly set in, as it's supposed to be. And it's going to be that way all afternoon. So I'm going to get the leading rod out, have a little feel over a zone that I've fished before in this swim. I've been in here a couple of times. See if it's the same, see if anything's changed. Start hatching the plan together. Really hard there. So that's an area I've fished before and it used to be quite soft. Now anything on here from sort of 19 to 21 is the range I'd say most people fish at. Now out there I'd be looking for a softer drop just to try and be a bit different. I think that gravel is so blatant. But in here, only 15 wraps I am now. It's not fished as much, so I don't mind fishing the gravelier sort of clearer areas. And if I can find a bit of silt, ideally I will. Or slightly even softer drop. Really hard that area now. You know what, I'm just going to fish on that hard. Yeah, happy with that. I prepared a mix similar to one that has served me really well on Sandhurst previously. A mix of crumb and whole boilies, bloodworm pellets, salt and GLM. All soaked in the pure tuna hydro. Once left to soak, I got to work with the spawn. So, just putting a bit of bait out, made a bucket up. The plan is to put half of it out now. I think there's a lot to be said on these day ticket venues for leaving your lines out of the water. So, I'm gonna get half of it out now, sit on my hands all afternoon, tie some rigs, have a few cups of tea, just relax and let everyone else do the damage. Like everyone's at it. They're casting, spomming, leading, you know, leave my area quiet with a bit of bait in. Then on dark, I'm gonna put the rest of the bait out and my rigs set for the morning. Hopefully by that time, decent amount of fish will have congregated in the swim. They'll have had a free feed by proper bite time tomorrow. Hopefully we'll have it off. Well, as you can see, it is still raining and it's going to continue to do so for some time. So just taking shelter, doing a bit of rig prep. I've chose to go all three on Ronnie's, little 12 mil pink signatures, and yeah, get them all wrapped up, ready for this evening. The fish were really active while I prepared my rigs and I was itching to get them out there. I went with two pink and one white, all on the ever faithful Ronnie rigs. It's my go-to for most scenarios over reasonably clean ground now. They sit low enough to be unobtrusive, yet high enough to ensure they stay clear of any sparse debris. As the rain poured down, the Ronnies went out perfectly and I sat back awaiting some action. Thank you.
Perfect. Well, that's me all out. Rods and the bait couldn't have gone any better. It's still raining, as you can see, but there is a lot of big carp out in front of us. Really looking forward to that morning period. I think if it's going to go off, it'll be in the morning. There's always a chance of one at night, but until then, I'm going to get under the old brolly, dry off, cook a bit of dinner, and set that alarm for tomorrow morning. Well, it was a relatively quiet night. About 1:30 I woke up. There was a lot of shows sort of out to my right in second pipes and left islands water. Once I was awake and sort of I'd clocked onto them, it was hard to get back off. But yesterday I didn't get here till about 10:30, and when I did, they were really active. There was bites around the pond. Sort of seemed to me, I know it was only the one day, but in the morning they sort of come down into my zone. Then as the day goes on into night, they drift back up the pond. So still hopeful that bite time's around that sort of mid-morning to lunchtime, sort of prime time. So we'll sit here patient, and rods are all out. I know everything's sweet, so just time to sit on my hands, really. Well, I really do feel like bite time has been and gone now. I had a little let up in an area of the lake or the swim that I saw a few this morning. Sort of quite a bit of fizzing in that zone. There's a real nice channel in between a couple of real big weed beds. Sort of some broken silt. Felt really nice. So I'm going to get two out there for this evening. Leave one out on the spot from yesterday, but I'm going to get to it. I want to get these ready. There could be a chance of a bite before dark. With a nice new spot located close to the fish activity and two rods already positioned on the zone, I spawned some bait out over the top of the rigs. It's funny how things play out though, as whilst doing so, the one remaining rod on the original spot ramped off and I found myself playing my first fish of the session. Well, that was about 10 minutes away from being reeled in. Knew they were in the zone, but yeah, that is a proper bite out of the blue. That just goes to show you just never know. It turned up this afternoon. It might have been the lack of pressure from the lines, you know. I took two rods away from that zone, probably, I don't know what it had been, 1/2 hour, 45 minutes later, I've got a bite. I don't think that is what it is, to be fair. I think it's more likely fish have been building up in that zone, and time was right. Nevertheless, we've got one on. Well, these are not the conditions that I expected to get a bite in at all. And as we speak, one has just rocked out over that new zone. Oh, he's a nice one. He is a nice one. Little pink squid hanging out of his mouth.
nice mirror, livery looking one. That'll do nicely. Oh,
well, I really didn't think that was going to happen. And I'm so, so grateful it has. This weather just was not the one. I've been pacing up and down, absolutely fretting, not knowing really what to do. I knew they were on me this afternoon and I was getting a bit of a panic on, to be fair, but chuffed with him. Yeah, he's a nice one, real nice one. Look at him, he's a lovely one. Today hasn't gone to plan, if I'm honest. They didn't turn up this morning, they just weren't here. But throughout the day, sort of early afternoon, there was a lot of carp turned up in the area, but the weather was not favourable. Bright sunshine, very little wind. And to be honest, this bite came out of nowhere. I moved a couple of rods along into the pond, left one on the previous evening spot, and 45 minutes with one rod on the spot, and this one turned up, absolutely made up, and I've still got 24 hours to go. Right, last rod, a little bit of bait, then we're gonna chill out for the evening. Oh my days, that couldn't have gone any better, that. I absolutely love spot fishing and I'm very meticulous in the way I go about it. I like to know exactly how that spot is sitting, where the weed is, how deep it is, how wide it is, which spots are harder, which spots are softer, and I can just start to work out where I want to be within the spot, how much bait am I going to use, you know, how many fish are in the area, do I want to bait one side of the spot heavier or the middle of the spot heavier, or, you know, I have baited spots really central and fish to either side of it, you know, it's really interesting way of fishing, and I love like piecing that puzzle together bit by bit by bit. And along the journey as well, things change and they can catch you out. There'll be circumstances, for example, where one side of the spot might be fishing better than the other, or three rods on the spot might be too much. I've had times where I've wound a rod or two in and the rod that's left is gone, indicating that one rod would be better. On the other hand, I've fished a single spot and it's built so well that it needs a second rod and then a third rod. It's a real special way of fishing for me, and it's super active and I love that. Like, one of my favourite times of the year is spring, because you're active, you're always doing something, and that's how I feel when I'm spot fishing. Like, I have all my rigs ready, you know, exactly the same length. I like things just a certain way, and it gives me a chance to put my OCD into practice and use it to its best ability. Well, the rods went out perfect. Literally couldn't have gone any better. It's been a glorious evening. The carp are still in the area. There was a lot in front of me this afternoon. So going into the night, I'm quietly confident, but that morning period is prime time and I'm really looking forward to it. Literally, they have gone perfect. So, just had an early morning bite. I can just see my horizon now. Rig's already back out, so I'm just putting, I'll probably put 3 spons over the top. It looks so good this morning, much better to yesterday and the morning before. So, we'll have a coffee and then we'll show you this carp.
There we go. First one of the morning. It's looking really good out there. Seen one or two, a little bit of fizzing. Looks much better than yesterday and the day before. Sandhurst is known for its big commons though, so I'm hoping luck's with me and I might be able to manage one before we go. This one's probably mid-20. Really lovely looking clean fish. Let's get her back. He's a lovely one, isn't he? Really dark, mint. Well, mate, hopefully you're not the last.
Sandhurst is one of the most renowned day tickets in the country. At 14 acres, it is absolutely full of biggins. 350 plus carp in it, the facilities are absolutely amazing, and in my opinion, it is one of the best in the country. Well, I really felt there was another chance at a bite today, but it just didn't happen. And as time sort of ticked on, the chance just felt like it faded away. I love this lake. Sandhurst is really cool, but it certainly comes with its challenges. It definitely hasn't been easy this session, but I still really feel like there's another chance out there. So the cameramen are gonna go and I'm gonna stay on another night. Well, the lake looks completely different to what it did a few months ago when I was here. It's now early March, arrived this morning, and luckily I've had pick of the litter. Spoke to a few of the chaps before, and it's really obvious that there's a big group of fish down one end. Now, I'm in that swim, there's a lot of activity out there at the minute, lots of fizzing, seen a couple show, so I'm gonna get the rods off the barra, get a couple of rigs onto that area, and hopefully nick an early bite.
That's the one.
Having spoken to the lad who fished the swim before me, I knew he'd caught over plenty of bait, so after a few hours of fishing singles, I decided to put a few spombs of Manila Active and sweet corn over the rigs to try and entice a bite. As the day drew on and the light began to fade, I repositioned the rods before depositing another hit of Manila and corn. I was brimming with confidence this time, and for a change, it all went out perfectly.
That literally couldn't have gone any better. Three rods out for three casts. I put probably 20 spombs on a bin lid. If they're here, then I'm catching them. It's down to them now.
That was a super quiet night. It lashed down with rain early hours for quite a while as well, but you could now hear a pin drop, so it was the perfect morning for seeing them. So I'm hoping that they're gonna give themselves away somewhere. Obviously in this swim would be ideal. But yeah, eyes peeled, That's the kettle boiling behind me, so first brew of the morning, I think. Well, there's another one. So we just walked down the bank to have a look, and that's the fourth carp now. Three real subtle, but I've just seen that one clear as day. Spread over quite a big zone, to be fair, but there's one swim in particular, peg 11, which I think puts you slap bang in the middle of the shows. We're gonna have to move. Yeah, that one's trailing up as well. Yeah, I'm gonna start wrapping a few bits up and get down. That's the most activity in probably 20 minutes that I've seen since we've been here, so, yeah. So the plan is, there's no pressure on the lake at all, hardly anything. Bearing in mind, it's used to seeing sort of 20 anglers 7 days a week. There's three or four of us on, so I do not want to be making too much noise. They're out there. Just want to get out as effectively and quickly as I can. So I'm going to put the lead out. This swim sort of fishes up to, this one just showed there, fishes up to about 21, 22 wraps, I think is the max out of here. So I'll probably wrap up to that. The first bit of clear ground I find in the clip, I'm probably going to put 6 to 10 spoms out, 3 rods, and that'll be it, done. Disturbance all done at once. And hopefully we can make something materialise. Bump. Literally granite. I might just see. That's it. Done.
With a new spot found, I set about casting my rigs into the zone, again on Ronnie's, but I mixed up the colours once again and tried to force a bite. Soon after the rigs went out, I followed them up with a sprinkling of bait, but not too much, half a small bucket's worth. Early spring's normally a prolific time of year on Sandhurst, but with the snow forecast for the morning, let's say I was more hopeful than expectant as the sun started to set. The worrying thing for me is that when they are feeding on here, you know about it. You know, they're fizzing, showing. Now we are seeing them, but they're just so subtle. Tiny little head pokes. Like, there's no question we are right on them. It's just, we just need them to feed. And I really do think at some point in the next 24 hours, there will be an opportunity. There'll be a window, I know there'll be a window. There's no way you can be on that many carp, or near that many carp, and at some point, on a full moon, with the pressure as low as it is, after being as high as it is, or was, sorry, that they're not gonna drop and have a feed. Not having it. Well, we're all huddled in the bivvy, freezing, for the worst night's sleep ever.
It's rained and snowed, kicked an easterly up, blew the front pegs out of the bivvy. We're all absolutely dooming. Couple of beeps on the right hand rod, line's lifted up and we're in. With snow on the reel handles, absolutely shivering with a Sandhurst carp on. I'd love to say it's a big in, but it definitely isn't. But it's a snow carp. Well, not the reward I was hoping for, but I'll certainly take it. My hands are like ice, can't feel my fingers. Pretty little one. I mean, it's great to get a bite in these conditions, it's freezing, but I really, really want one of these better ones from Sandhurst. So I'm gonna get this back, warm my fingers up, get a bit of bait out. The 6th of March. The weather weren't like this when I caught them last time in March, that's for sure.
The snow set in for the rest of the day. I wanted one more go, so I booked another trip for a month later, crossing my fingers for better conditions and lady luck to shine on me.
Let's go.
Well, the conditions are completely different to how they were last time I was here, that's for sure. We were stood in sleet and snow and rain for most of the trip. Really bleak, really horrible, just awful. Today feels much more spring-like. Fish are on the surface. Which I know is mad because it's still pretty early. They've been on a big fly hatch the last few days. It's still showing now, ziggy shows like. Don't think it's done too many bites in the last 48 hours, but we're due a big pressure drop. Some rain is coming in. The fish are in front of me. I'm in the swim I wanted to get in. Fingers crossed, really. Hope they drop.
I quickly locate the spot amongst the weed and dispatch three rods, baited with match the hatch caught ball pop-ups, as this time I had a very specific plan in terms of my baiting strategy.
I think a few years ago when I came and I fished crumb with small hook baits on tight baited areas, it was an edge, but it's almost gone full circle now. I know there's a lot of lads that have done that and done really well on it. So I've gone back to my roots. Bigger baits, whole baits, spread them about a bit, tried to get the fish moving between baits, and hopefully that's going to nick me a bigger one.
Look at this. Proper hatch going off. Thousands of little skins, look. Don't they look like the TA White Zig Kickers? Slightly smaller. That is a sign that spring is definitely here, and also why the lads the last couple of days have found it so hard to get a bite. Mad.
Just feels it, doesn't it? That pressure's dropped. It just
for want of a better description, carpy, doesn't it? Like, it's just got that feeling in the air that we're going to catch a big Sandhurst common. I said that the last two times. I could feel that coming, it just felt really nice. I think I said earlier, not so long ago, half an hour ago, that I felt there was a bite on the cards. It just looked right, felt right. Those shows out to the left had just started to move out to the right. I said they'd do it, like they're over that weed out there to the left. I just felt as that sort of light started to drop a little bit and this rain set in, that they might move out. That is moving a lot of water, that fish. In fact, that is a really good carp. That is a big one, a proper big one. Oh, I don't know. Yeah. Yeah. That is a nice carp. Oh, do you know what? I don't think I've ever felt like I've deserved a carp more than that one. That is a proper big one. Oh, buzzing. Standing there freezing my arse off. That is a big carp. And I think I know what one it is. And if it is, we've talked him on. Yeah, stood there, what was that, a month ago? Freezing cold, sleet, hail, rain. Awful conditions. Another one's just showing over the bait there. And yeah, struggled in the September. We caught a couple, but you come to Sandhurst for a big one, and that is definitely a big one. There he is, the Sandhurst biggin we came for. Wasn't easy, I'm not gonna lie, like Sandhurst gave me a right whooping this time, third session lucky. It's just persistence, like this time of year, like winter, like you're relying on conditions being right. And it's not easy, like it's 20 odd swims on this lake and it's busy, you know, and they can easily not be on you. But they have been on me and I've still struggled, so that definitely feels like a bit of redemption for standing in that weather the other week with the boys who stuck by my side the whole way. Oh, 39.10. And I get the feeling that this isn't going to be the last. There he is, in some epic spring conditions. Just textbook fishing. An awesome time of year, one of my absolute favourites. And yeah, the old tactics have come right. Never doubt what you know best and what you have most confidence in. Ah, made up, absolutely made up. He's not gonna be the last either. Well, it has been an absolute grueler, I'm not gonna lie.
There's been times where I've been pacing the banks, absolutely dooming. It hasn't gone the way I wanted it to, but to land that proper old Sandhurst original and a big one as well, that's why we came here, I'm absolutely made up. Since that bite, things have gone a little bit quieter, to be fair. So going into the night, I'm not as confident as I thought I would be, or certainly as I was slipping that one back a little while ago, but you never know. They can turn up on your ear really quickly and they can leave just as quick. So yeah, heading into the night, we'll see what happens. But to be honest, I'm not really too fussed. Got the one that I wanted and a big one that we came for. So yeah, made up. Well, it was a quiet night on the fishing front, but they were super active. I wouldn't even like to say how many shows I saw. I woke up at 2, got up for a pee, and it was just relentless. They're all out on front, still on a hatch, obviously. There's still skins in the edge this morning, but we caught one. Still absolutely buzzed about that fish. So I think there is still a chance. Like, bite time was late yesterday afternoon. I'm gonna give it probably till midday. Redo the rods, fresh hook baits, maybe a few fresh bombs over the top just to sort of liven things up a bit, and then get settled, hopefully, for that same period that I caught one in yesterday. The last three sessions I've been using the spinner rig. It's a rig that I've got an awful lot of confidence in, and I find myself using it actually in most scenarios now. The hooking properties are just phenomenal. I can honestly say I don't think I've lost a single carp on this rig. Once it's in, it is not coming out. Now, for me, springtime is all about the pop-ups. Getting them over that low-line silkweed that's full of naturals, that's where they want to feed in, and that's where I want to get my hook bait. In most scenarios now, I find myself using the 35-pound tongue skin. It's really, really supple and heavy, so it sinks and follows the contours, but at the same time it's stiff enough that I can honestly say I don't get tangles with it at all. It's a really, really good product. It knots super well and is really, really strong, and it's just one of those things that I turn to now with 100% confidence. I tie the tongue skin straight to the ring swivel. I personally really don't like a loop there. I think it just offers too much movement. The way I tie it like that with the putty, it sort of holds it in place and the hook sits cocked like a claw, ready to grab. I then take a size 4 curve shank hook and I use about 14 mil of the medium shrink tube. Now, I really like the shrink tube to cover the crook of the swivel and come down over the barrel. Again, it's just minimizing that small movement and keeping that hook cocked over, ready to grab the bottom lip, as I said before. I then add a hook ring swivel followed by a black hook bead. I align the hook bead up with the barb of the hook. I don't want it to go too far around because I think it can be prone to tangles. And then it's just a case of attaching the hook bait and it's ready to go. It's just a rig that I've got an awful lot of confidence in. A few years ago when I did really well, I was using little bright ones. But I mean, that was probably 4 or 5 years ago now. They've probably been absolutely done to death. So this session, I adopted a bit of a different approach and went for the match the hatch. And I mean, we've caught a big one. And as far as I'm aware, according to the bailiffs, that fish hasn't been out since last March. So I'm thinking it's worked. However, the lads that were on before me, I knew a few of them. And I think there was 9 lads on for 3 nights. They had 10 bites, all 10 bites were on white. And I don't think that's coincidence. I'm sure it's not where they were all using white, so that was all they caught. From what I can gather, that sort of became a bit of a theme. They started changing over and thus got more bites. So I'm gonna put 2 match the hatch and 1 white one on just to see. Now, if I was to predict what would happen, and I'm sticking my neck on the line, I would guess that if I would get a bite off the white one, it would be from a smaller one. More than likely a stocky, and the big ones would come off the match the hatch, but we'll see, you never know. So these are my little homemade cork balls. I've messed around with them quite a lot over the years, and
Yeah, these, because they're from Aronis, they've only got a little cork ball in. I think it's a 10 mil. This time of year, I like my hook baits to be maximum attraction. So by wrapping them in tights, it means you can boil them for less time. So you've almost got a paste underneath that is pumping out attraction. And if you notice on these ones, that the ones I've taken off, literally it is just a mush inside. And literally they still smell as good as they did when, you know, when I rolled them. They can be a bit of a faff because you can't blob them down like you do a normal pop-up, because as soon as that heat touches the tights, it'll fray the tights. So I've just come up with this little technique where just put a bait stop in, just with an overhand granny knot, like so. Then another loose one over the top. At this point, you have to be quite careful, because if you pull it too tight, you yank the hook bait right down onto the hook ring swivel. And then what that'll do is twist that up like that. Cut it quite short. Be really careful that that flame doesn't rock and touch the tights. So it's a bit of a faff, it is, especially in the wind. There you go. That's that melted down, ready to go. Yes, perfect. Got it. So I put half a dozen or eight out this morning. Haven't had a bite today, so I'm presuming most, if not all, that bait is still there. So just put four or five out now just to top up. Well, it was a quiet afternoon, really. That weather phase came through, sun came out after, and it really was glorious. It was really nice to sit in, spring sun on your face, but carp are gone to ground. They're not showing like they were. They're definitely still in the area, and the rods went out really sweet earlier. So yeah, going into the night, there's been a few bites through the nighttime period. So yeah, we'll see what it brings. Well, with an hour to go, we've got one. Just doing a bit to camera saying that it's been an odd morning. They'd been up on the surface everywhere, like, just looked real ziggy. One of the lads that packed up a bit earlier just walked into the swim and said he'd seen some fizzing out to my left. So literally split second thought of maybe there's a chance of a bite. And with that,
The middle rod's gone. Oh, can't believe it. Literally, just having a coffee, watching them all backs out of the water, cruising around thinking, what is going on? Like, just crazy, crazy activity this morning. Dooming a little bit, to be honest. I was already in the van on the way home in my head, and out of nowhere, middle rods dropped back, ramped off, and yeah, looks like we've got a 30 pound mirror, and it's one of the old ones as well. So got to be off in about half an hour, 40 minutes, so we need to get a bit of a rig on, get this done. .32 on the button. Well, there we go. That is going to be the end of a trio of sessions on Sandhurst. I'm not going to lie, it's been a bit of a grueler at times, but with that mega one yesterday and this one to finish off, that is why we come here and yeah, put ourselves through it. That's a mega one, that. Well chuffed. What an end to a great little period of angling.